top crane. Today we are headed up by Bethany, Missouri. We're going to do a bridge job. I think it's 3 precast beams, about 100 feet long. I think total weight 66,000. I'm only going to have half of it. We got another crane company that's bringing, I think they're 120 ton hydro up to set up on the other side. We came up and looked at the site a few days ago. It looked a little bit sketchy. It was really, really muddy. Hopefully it's dried out some, and they were going to do some dirt work, kind of build me a crane pad. We'll see how that went. We're going to have 3 counterweights, so I'm going to have 2 trucks with me, and it's a little bit confined. All right, we're getting close to our bridge job. It's kind of crazy to me that they're building the kind of bridges they are on these little bitty county roads. This road actually gets smaller when we get it by that bridge. If I'm not mistaken, it has grass growing up in the middle of it. But I don't get it. And I understand farmers need access to their fields. I'm not opposed to that by any means. But they're building these really expensive precast bridges on these little bitty tiny roads, and I don't understand it. But I mean, I guess once they're there, they're going to be there for quite a while. And Mike, in case you're following me, but it's so dusty I can't see him. Not even traveling very fast. I'm only going 22. We made an oncoming vehicle, they're gonna have to pull off in the ditch. Previewed this job and I saw this road, I was thinking this road was their access to their field. I was like, why would they be putting a bridge right there? This is actually a county road.
Company's rig. Oh, okay.
He didn't want to use it because he didn't want to walk with the beam. We're gonna jump out and see what we got to work with here. All right, so here's our current situation. We've got both cranes set up. This is another crane company. They're out of Kansas City. With Liebherr LTM 1130. So it's 155 American ton hydro. He's going to handle the far end, naturally. I'm going to handle my end, but the bridge beams are about 90 feet long, I think, and the beam manufacturer, Holler, or whoever, they didn't put steerables underneath the back end. So typically when you haul stuff that long, you have steerable axles on the back side so you can get around these corners. But they didn't do that, so they're having a lot of difficulty getting into the site. And then now, I think they're stuck right in the middle of the road. But we've been sitting here for a couple hours, just waiting on beams to get here. And it's not happening. So, oh well, I guess it is what it is. If you're gonna operate a crane, you gotta have some patience. But we'll start recording when we actually start doing something. Alright, there's beam number one. Axle. there. And then get him lined up a little bit. Okay, we got the first one here hooked up. I was told it's really close to the back end of that truck, so instead of compensating for my deflection, I'm just going to let it kind of run away from me. So I'm at a 52.3 foot radius, and if I let it drift away about a foot, then that'll give us a little more clearance between us and the truck. So ordinarily, when you pick a piece like this, you want it to come straight up. As you're cabling up, you have to boom up to account for the boom bending and the chassis bending, chassis of the crane bending under the load. But in a case like this, we want the piece to move away from that truck. We're not going to compensate for that deflection. We're just going to cable up. And that should let that piece drift backwards some. Or it'll drift away from the crane. But the way we're configured, we've got 86.1 feet of boom length, 79,000 pounds of counterweight, full outrigger span. And the boom boat that I put it in, it put section 5, which is the smallest section, at 46%. And then section 4 and section 3, the same. Okay, so we're cabling up on it now. We've got about 8,000 pounds on it. I'm not going to compensate for my deflection. I'm just going to let it drift away from me. There, we got about 14,000 on it, 15. Doing that way it spins him around with me. fact that he'll be actually kind of pushing me around. Okay, so now we're going to start booming it down and taking it away. number three. I forgot to record beam number two.
That happens.
This guy, he made it in here without an issue, but if he didn't quit hopping that truck, he may end up spitting a drive shaft out the bottom. Twisting an axle off. Once we get this one and the next one set, it'll be time to start tearing down. And it is now 4 o'clock. So,
probably going to be a 13-hour day today.
Oh well, it is what it is. At least it's Friday.
Middle of pickup.
my door open here, and we're gonna catch this truck driving out of here. I got a sneaking suspicion. This guy's gotta come up a pretty steep hill, and I got a sneaking suspicion he's gonna be pretty heavy with his right foot. The first truck that had to pull him. This truck looks like it's got a bent front bumper, but no place to hook a tow hook unless it's behind his license plate.
tear down, drive 2 hours home.